Now, it often happens that when doing something like an exam on Tomasulo's algorithm, we just care, for example, like in what cycle something issues or in what cycle something finishes and so on, or how many cycles it took overall. So let's go through an example that is just trying to track the timing and not trying to keep track of everything in every structure and so on, just to kind of show you how to do this on exams. So we will have the same processor, the same instructions, the same issue execute write, but we're going to try to do that without having all of those tables in. So let's try to go through this example. What's going to happen is we kind of need to know how many reservation stations we have for each type of instructions, and that's the only thing that we're kind of going to be missing a little bit. So basically, in the first cycle, we know we can issue this and nothing else will happen. In the next cycle, we know we can execute this, and then because it takes three cycles, we know that we're going to try to write it in cycle four. So kind of mark this tentatively now for cycle four. In the next cycle, we will be issuing this load here. If we consider the same condition that the load cannot overlap with another load, then we know that in 2 and 3, this is going to execute so that this can begin execution in 4 and then execute in 5 and try to broadcast in 6. In cycle 3, we're going to be issuing this. It uses a different unit. So again, you have to check basically in cycle 3, is there an available multiply unit, but kind of looking at what's currently using the reservation stations. And then you have to check for dependencies. So for example, this is waiting for F2 and F4. F2 is produced by the second load. So actually, this will not be able to execute until cycle 7. 6 here means that basically we will have 7. And we can kind of mark here that our F2 comes from instruction 2, which is why we had to execute only in the cycle that follows its write. Because this is a multiplication, add 10 cycles to that, we're going to try to write the result in cycle 17. The subtract is going to issue in the very next cycle if there are available reservation stations, because so far we have used no add reservation stations that's going to be able to issue. The subtract is going to wait for 2 and 6, so the later of the two loads is really when we can start. So we can start in cycle 7, and we will mark here again that, you know, we are waiting, kind of just give an indication, like what was the delay somewhere. And then it's a subtract, so it's going to finish in cycle 7, 8, so it's going to try to write the result in 9. Next, we're going to consider this divide. Can it issue in cycle 5? Well, yes, it can, because so far only one unit is used and we have two such, only one reservation station is used and we have two of them. So the question is, when can it execute? Well, look for F0 and F6. F0 comes from the multiply at 17, F6 comes at 4, so we will be able to execute in cycle 18 here, because we were waiting for F0 like this, and it's a divide, so it's gonna try to broadcast at cycle 58. Next, we're gonna consider what's the next issue cycle. Well, 6, this add is gonna issue in 6 because, again, we have units. It's gonna look for F8 and F2, whichever is the latest. 2 is at 6. F8 is at 9, so it's going to start executing in cycle 10, execute in cycle 11, try to broadcast in cycle 12, and we're going to mark that F8 comes from instruction 4. And now, because we've been kind of doing this out of order, we have to check just, are there any two instructions that are actually writing in the same cycle? If yes, then we'll have to redo this. Basically, we have to postpone some of the writes in order for that to happen. But because these are all different cycles, everything is fine. And this concludes our timing example. So basically, now we know in which cycle each instruction executes issues and writes, and when does this all end, without really having to go through all of those things. So if we are only worried about timing, then we can do something like this.